Good afternoon and welcome to St. John the Baptist Catholic Parish in Costa Mesa to our Latin Mass in the Extraordinary Form. Today's Holy Mass is the Mass of Septuagesima Sunday, so we are in purple vestments and there is no Gloria. The Gloria is gone now until, I think, Holy Thursday. These are the announcements. Wednesday is the Memorial of St. Blaise, and we will offer the special prayer of blessing of the throats at the weekday Masses. So that's at the 8:30 Mass and at the 5:30 p.m. Mass. St. Joseph Holy Cards are available in the back of the church and at the entranceway to the courtyard. Special thanks to the Cup family for donating the Holy Cards and the beautiful Year of St. Joseph banner set up in the back of the church. Please donate your old palm branches to the parish to be burned to make the ashes for Ash Wednesday. You may turn them into the parish office or bring them to Mass over the next two Sundays. You will also notice there are some envelopes in the back of the church and in each entrance for the school's annual appeal. And I work here, and I have the privilege of working with the servers that come over to serve the daily school Masses. They have Mass every day for the school children. And I am never fail to be impressed by the depth and the wonderful job the school does in inculcating the faith to the boys and girls that go to Mass here. I mean, that go to school here and Mass. So if you can possibly make a donation to the school's annual appeal, the envelopes are around and you can just take it and drop it in next week or mail it to the school, whatever the case may be. But they would really appreciate it. They did have some extra costs this year. They did open in person since September. And they've done a great job with that, and they've been keeping it in person. But they had to ran into some extra costs that they had to do for tents and technology. So please check the bulletin in our parish website for other announcements and information. And today's Holy Mass is offered for the intentions of Christina Ford and family. And now the prayer to St. Michael. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Asperges me. Patria et Filio, Ostend de nobis Domine misericordiam tuam.
Et salutare tuum dan nobis.
Domine exaudi orationem meam.
Et clamor meus a te veniam.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Oremus, exaudi nos Domine Sancte Pater Omnipotens, Eterne Deus, et mitere digneris Sanctum Angelum Tuum de Celis, qui custodiat foviat protegat, visiter atque defendat omnes habitantes in hoc habitaculo, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Dolores in fere.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Oremus. Reces populi tui quesmus Domine clementer exaudi, ut qui iuse pro peccatis nostris affligimur, pro tui nominis gloria misericordita liberemur. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Lectio Epistolae Beati Pauli Apostoli ad Corinthios. Fratres, nescitis quod ii quid in stadio curunt, omnes quidem curunt, sed unus accipit bravium, sicurite ut comprehendatis. Omnis autem qui in agone contendit, ad omnibus se abstinent, et illi quidem ut corruptibilem coronam accipiant, nos autem incorruptam. Ego igitur sicuro, non quasi incertum, sic pugnon non quasi aerem verberans, sed castigo corpus meum, et in servitutem redigo. Ne forte cum aliis predicaverim, ipse reporpus efficiar. Nolo enim vos ignorare, fratres, quoniam patres nostri omnes sub nube fuerunt, et omnes mare transierunt, et omnes in Moise baptisati sunt in nube et in mari, et omnes eam dem escam spiritalem mandecaverunt, et omnes eundem potum spiritalem biberunt. Bibebant autem de spiritali, consequente eos petra, petra autem erat Christus, sed non in pluribus eorum bene placitum est Deo.
Thank you.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Sequentia sancti evangelii secundum Matteum.
Gloria tibi, Domine.
In illo tempore dixit Iesus discipulus suis, parabulam hanc, simile est regnum celorum homini patri familias, qui exit primo mani conducere operarios in vineyam suam. Conventione autem facta cum operariis ex denario diurno miset eos in vineyam suam. Et egressus circa horam tertiam, vidit alios stantes in foro otiosos, et dixit illis, ite et vos in vineyam meam, et pod justum fuerit dabo vobis. Ili autem abierunt, iterum autem exit circa sextam et nonam horam, et fecit similiter. Circa undecimam vero exit, et invenit alios stantes, et dicit illis, quid hic satis tota die otiosi. Dicunt ei, quia nemo nos conduxit. Dicit illis, ite et vos in vineyam meam. Cum sero autem factum eset, dicit Dominus vinea procuratori suo, voca operarios, et redi illis mercedem, incipiens a novissimis usque ad primos. Cum venissen ergo qui circa undecimam horam venerant, acceperunt singulos denarios. Venientes autem et primi, arbitratis sunt quod plus esse accepturi, acceperunt autem et ipsi singulos denarios. Et accipientes murmurabunt adversus patrem familias dicentes, hi novissimi una hora fecerunt, et pares illos nobis fecisti, qui portavimus pondis diei et estus. Et ille respondens uni eorum dixit, amice, non facio tibi injuriam, non ex denario convenisti mecum. Tole quo tuum es et vade, volo autem et huic novissimo dare sicut et tibi. Aut non licet mi quod volo facere, an oculus suus nequam es, quia ego bonus sum. Sic erot novissimi primi, et primi novissimi. Multi enim sunt vocati, pauci vero electi. His car, her looks, the marriage and children, the perfect life of someone else. We all fall victim to the well-known trap of comparison when we look at what others have and compare it to our own. Theodore Roosevelt, the 26th president of our nation, said it best about comparison when he exuberantly stated, "Comparison is the thief of joy." Now, how can comparison be a thief of joy? Starting with the source of this famous quote, Theodore Roosevelt was someone who viewed life with a joyful attitude. Seldom do we see any photos where President Roosevelt was not giving an ear-to-ear grin to all those around him, which is unique when you hear the trials he experienced in his life. Losing his first wife and mother on the same day in 1884, Roosevelt regained his emotional footing while on his ranch in Dakota Territory. He went on to be an esteemed lieutenant colonel during the Spanish-American War and became the youngest president in history at the age of 42 when he became president in 1901 after the assassination of his predecessor, William McKinley. Well before Roosevelt spoke these iconic words, the Bible was and still is the manual to shine a light on comparison pitfalls and ways we can avoid comparison to appreciate what we have now. Comparing oneself to others was a chronic problem among many over the centuries and is frequently discussed in the Bible. The problem is described among those we are familiar with in scriptures. Rachel and Leah, Jacob and his brothers, and the disciples of our Lord. St. Paul wrote, "Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me or seen in me, put it into practice, and the God of peace will be with you. For I have learned to be content, whatever the circumstances. I know what it is to be in need, and I know what it is to have plenty. I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation, whether living in plenty or in want." So how do we get to this state of contentment the Apostle Paul spoke about? This state with God that comparison cannot touch. There are ways to keep comparison at bay or removed altogether. And they can be as simple as the changing of our thoughts from a previous mindset to a new one. Firstly, make a physical or mental list of areas in your life where comparison is the strongest. Marital status, career, material resources, spiritual gifts. This will help you come to terms with where you find comparison to rear its ugly head. Secondly, write out some people's names, to whose lives you compare your life, and list what areas you compare yourself to them. This is not a list to make fun of them or have hurtful thoughts toward them, but to be more aware of the comparisons you are making. And thirdly, look at each person's name and remind yourself that just as you are a fallen sinner in need of our Lord's saving grace, that person needs him daily as well. They may seem to have everything together on the outside, but they could be crippled by comparison and the opinions of others, just as much as the rest of us. The same practice can be applied toward the areas of comparison you struggle with, as you can remind yourself that even if you had the best that life has to offer in these areas, you would not be happy, free, or feel as loved as you do when you have our Lord. And finally, whenever you feel comparison rise up again, pray to God about the situation, person, or feeling, and ask for his strength and discernment to be freed from the snares of this comparison trap. These are three ways to fight the good fight against comparison. Now, what about ways to keep your joy intact against the thief comparison? Firstly, remember not only the times when God answered your prayers, but also the times when he gave you the unexpected blessings that you never asked from him. Secondly, when overcome by sadness or hopelessness, do something that brings you joy, whether it is reading a book, calling, seeing a friend, taking a walk, activities that take your mind off of sadness. Thirdly, do an act of kindness. An act of kindness boosts the spirit of both persons. From today's parable, the landowner said to the disgruntled laborer who compared his equal pay to another laborer who worked fewer hours, "Friend, I do you no injustice, for did you not agree with me to a day's pay? So take your pay and go your way." One interesting and very significant detail that we seldom are referred to is the landowner's command, "Take your pay. Take your pay and go your way." In Greek, the verb also means to lift up and carry away. So in the parable, the disgruntled worker either refused to take the silver coin or threw it on the ground. One wonders at the ragged display of emotion in the unhappy laborer. Oftentimes, when we are upset with God regarding our circumstances, we refuse the blessings that he is giving to us. Comparison is, in fact, a thief of joy. But it does not need to be a constant battle we have to wage every day. Comparison may have stolen moments of happiness in your past, but it does not need to steal your present state of joy. William Penn said, "The secret to happiness is to count your blessings while others are adding up their troubles." And for us, followers of our blessed Lord, let us count our blessings twice.
Credo in unum Deum,
Jesu Christum.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Oremus. Omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Sursum corda. Gratias agamus, Domino Deo nostro. Verit ignem et justum est, secum et salutare. Nos tibi semper ubique, gratias agere. Domine sancte pater omnipotens, eterne Deus, qui cum unigenito filio tuo et spiritu sancto, unus est Deus, unus est Dominus. Non in unius singularitate personae, sed in unius Trinitate substantiae. Quod enim de tua gloria revelante te credimus, hoc de filio tuo, hoc de spiritu sancto, sine differentia discretionis sentimus. Ut in confessione vere semper tenque deitatis, et in personis proprietas, et in essentia unitas, et in maestate adoretur equalitas. Quam laudan angeli atque arcangeli, cherubim quoque ac seraphim, qui non cessan clamare quotidie, una voce dicentes.
nobis quoque peccatoribus.
Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus, preceptis salutaribus moniti, et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere, Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum. Adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem.
Et libera nos ad malo.
Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Amen.
Spirito vestri, omnipotente, et dimissis peccatis vestris, perjugatus, et vitam eterna. Indulgentiam solutionem et remissionem peccatorum vestorum, tribuat vobis omnipotentem misericus dominimus.
Ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccata mundi. Domine non sum dignus rintere subjectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et senabitur anima mea. Domine non sum dignus rintere subjectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et senabitur anima mea. Domine non sum dignus rintere subjectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et senabitur anima mea.
Salome, Father.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Oremus. Fidelis tui Deus perdona firmentur, ut eadem et percipiendo requirant, et querendo sine fine percipiant, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Ite. Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.